that star up in the sky, from that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope. When my back's against the ropes, I can feel it. I'm the world's greatest.
Before the 2019 general elections, about 400 youth candidates who ran for various offices under various political parties across Nigeria converged for a conference. The convergence, power, capacity and politics was designed by Yaga Africa to inspire and equip the young candidates with relevant information for running effective campaigns. As part of its continuous support for engaging leaders, Yaga Africa organized the second edition of the convergence, tagged Leadership, Power and Politics. This brings you to the program, Youth Can. I am your host, Osawoname Ibizuwe.
I'm invited here to highlight this convergence as a keynote speaker, but I must warn that this key I'm about to deliver is long, and so I'll crave your indulgence to oblige me, because I've put my thought on paper because of the nature of the audience I'm addressing today, so that I don't miss anything. Today, as always, I find it worthwhile, very worthwhile endeavor, to speak about our country and its latent potentials exemplified by those of you here, millions of others who you now represent. A country has never been in short supply of those who tell truth to power. But finding those opportune, such as you are now, to execute the clarion call of nation building. However, despite the foregoing, the Nigerian youth has, since our nation's return to democratic rule in 1999, been kept on the wings and fringes of leadership. By the position of this document, we refuse to see the Nigerian youth as merely a representation of tomorrow's leadership, but a distinct social category of people who are educated, competent, prepared for the task of today's leadership. A few examples of our national history buttress the fact that when given the opportunity, the Nigerian youth possesses the capacity to lead, and to lead with distinction. Let me begin by quickly reminding you of the immortal words of one of African finest, the late Mr. Kofi Annan, a former Secretary General of the United Nations, who said, and I quote, "No one is born a good citizen. No nation is born a democracy. Rather, but are processes that continue to evolve over a lifetime. Young people must be included from birth. A society that cuts itself off from its youth severs its lifeline. It is condemned to bleed to death," end of quote. It is because of this and many other important factors that support the 8th National Assembly to pass the Not Too Young to Run Bill into law. While there was cynicism from certain quarters as to the commitment of lawmakers to the passage of the bill, but as legislators, we were never in doubt as to the importance of the bill and how much youth energy will drive governance in our country. The Not Too Young to Run law is not so much about the exclusion of any particular class from the political space. Rather, it is designed to offer a platform for our youth population to build synergy with the segments of society for national development. As you have known by now, the law is not designed as a cutthroat competition between the young people and the old, but an opportunity to build a consensus, a sort of governance symphony where all energies are deployed for our common good. Let me thank the organizers of this conference, for young lawmakers at both the national and state levels. Also, I congratulate all of you on your elections, and I should add myself as representatives of our people, by extension, our country, Nigeria. The importance of your elections is situated in the fact that the Nigerian youth, our youth demographic, at an estimated population of 78 million, would be the fourth largest country in Africa and 19th largest country in the world if it were a country. But what have our sheer numbers, numerical strength, been put to? It is in the light of this that I find very interesting the theme for this conference, which is convergence, leadership, power, and politics. What this simply means is that you are now leaders, part of the elite, which some of you lead so much. It is instructive you begin to come to terms with the remarks that you are now part of Nademdem. So what this is all about is leadership. And the fact that we're here is leadership also that compels this attendance, because the passage of this bill wouldn't have been possible without the demonstration of true leadership. But I must tell you that it was very, very tough. For some of you who are beneficiaries, it was very, very tough. So the value that was instrumental in driving you to seek for office is what will define how you carry yourself, what effort you put into the art of lawmaking, and how much impact you desire to make, not for yourself, but for your constituents. The part of leadership, price of leadership, most of you already know, is mostly steep, sometimes frightening, if you're in it for the wrong reasons. It challenges your character, tests your patience, and risks your reputation. So in the end, it is what you choose to do with the leadership that has been conferred on you that will count. No one should envy you, because you are coming on board at a time our beloved country is on its knees, having ravaged our national blessings until we are now desperate to find redemption. I have no good news for you, my friends. This is a time like no other time. All of us know that in Nigeria. Do you know, for instance, that Nigeria is the third most dangerous country in the world to live in after Afghanistan and Syria? Tell me a single extended family in Nigeria that has not suffered the pains of kidnapping, banditry, or terrorism. Do you know that life expectancy in Nigeria is estimated by Open Government to be at 53.8 in 2017, which gives Nigeria a world life expectancy ranking of 214 out of 224 countries ranked? Do you know that one out of every three Nigerians go to bed hungry every night? To our shame, we have become a byword among nations who now tell us to our faces that we are now the poverty capital of the world. Do you know that we have no single world-class hospital and no world-class institution of learning? Consequently, medical tourism abroad is the accepted norm, with their consequences on our national economy. So many young people's life ambition nowadays is not to study in the Western world anymore, but anywhere except Nigeria. No need to remind us that unemployment is now officially at nearly 30%, if not more. And the employment is more grave, a problem in the country. So many out there working their hearts out for take homes that cannot take them home, much less put food on their tables. Let me stop here so as not to depress us any further. I don't want to sniff that youthful energy from us by telling us all this bad news. All that I've highlighted so far are actually not the disease. They are symptoms of the disease. We have no parallel in our history, as nothing in Nigeria's history prepares us for this. Nigeria's real disease is lack of leadership. I've always disagreed with all those who say our major national disease is financial corruption. Rather, the real disease has been the absence of true leadership, which in turn breeds moral corruption and wickedness. Get a true leader that solves moral corruption and wickedness. When that happens, he will search for financial corruption to no avail. Unfortunately, the leadership model we have practiced so far is the kind of leadership that produces sycophants who are expected to serve their political godfathers, not the people. Our so-called leaders have mastered the art of political witchcraft, so much so that if you are independent-minded, as some of you want to be, you are automatically disqualified. And if for any reason you are picked, then you have to surrender your soul for them to eat in small bites until you become their worshiper. In the midst of this pandemic sycophancy, our so-called godfathers expect us to fit in and not to stand up or to make the difference. We need leaders who will lead us to build a nation and serve others, not godfathers who demand that we worship and serve them rather than serve the people. For you trailblazers who carry the burden and the promises of a generation that must not fail, if you are ever going to get there, it must be on the wings of discipline that produces character. This is because without character, you cannot be men and women of influence. And without influence, you can't change anything.
Like we did in August during the celebration conference, we said, we celebrate Not Too Young to Run today because there was a Yakubu Dogara as the Speaker of the House of Representatives. And if you follow the story, we would say that these leaders actually demonstrated to us as young people what it means to be a public leader. And like Cynthia said this morning, that the whole advocacy for youth inclusion isn't just because we want to see young people in office. That's not the point. The point is our country is in dire need of excellent public leaders. Legislators who will consult with their people. And when they rise up on the floor of the chamber to say, I, so and so, speaking or representing this constituency, that you're doing so in the true sense of the word. And we want to see leaders who will hold the executive to account in performing oversight, quality oversight, and then also the quality of our legislations really need to improve at different level. And so when we talk about Not Too Young to Run, we're talking about leaders that will provide the excellent public leadership that Nigeria needs. And the burden is actually on you, and that is why we celebrate you today. But we also remind you of that burden, that as you become honorable members, or now that you're honorable members elect, and when you are inaugurated, that you are reminded of the fact that you went to hell to get the votes of people, and you are accountable to those people. And that is what your constituents need. And for us, that is what we stand for, and that is what we will continue to promote.
Sponsors of the Not Too Young to Run bill, talking about Senator Abdulaziz Iyanko from the Senate and Honorable Tony Umulu from the House of Representatives, who championed the cause of the Not Too Young to Run bill until it was passed into law by President Muhammadu Buhari in May 2018. Now let's listen to them speak on the convergence 1 and 2. We'll be right back.
It's a build-up on the act itself. It's not enough to have an act, but we must find means of actualizing the spirit of the act. So I think this convergence is to build up on what we have already done. Like I said earlier during the speech, the Civil Rights Act came into existence in the US in 1964 when it was signed by Lyndon Johnson. But the full meaning of the act was actualized in 2008 when Obama became the president of America. But it took about 44 years and it took processes to get there. So now we have, we are very proud to see about 17 legislators have been defeated from this bill. Those below the age of 30, we introduced 9 of them to us today. So it is clear that the bill is beginning, the act itself is beginning to work. Because history has, we've seen historically, young people have led nations. Alexander the Great led Macedonia from the age of 19. I think he passed away or died at the age of 30, 31. He led Macedonia and he was able to do this. There was a leader of the Visigoths who was at the age of 24. He led his country at the age of 24. We've had leaders like that. We've had leaders in Nigeria that were in their 20s. All the Chiwai and Jumas and all the Kawans and they were young people. They were able to lead this country. But it's not as simple as saying that we want to flush the elders. Far from it. The whole idea behind this bill is for the younger generation to interact with the older generation, so that over time, you have this transfer of experience from one generation to another. Then we will build on it gradually. But the best form of governance has to be a mix. You have elders, you have younger people, you have people midway, and of course there should be women.
Being the sponsor of the bill, how do I encourage them? Go out there, join the political party, join the political process, run for election. That's where it starts from. Those that have, I can only charge them to continue advocating for the youth, advocating for good governance, and living it through. And those that were not able to make it, I encourage them to try again. It captures everybody. I think the thing is that most Nigerian women should have faith in themselves and come out. The same way a lot of people were a bit skeptical. They didn't want to throw in the hat. You know, we've been told lies over and over again, and when you keep hearing these lies, you tend to believe that that is what it is. You have lies over politics being dirty. So you have a lot of people who want to abstain from politics. But today you see that nobody is wearing negative clothes, like I remarked then. So same thing goes for women. Enough of telling yourselves that, look, if I go in there, I am going to be this, I'm going to be sexually harassed. No, don't stay at home and think that those things happen. When you go there, you have the right to say no. That's the most important thing. Every other person has the right to choose what you want to do or what not to do. Do you get the point I'm trying to make? So it's not about competence, it's not about anything, but about convincing yourself that yes, you can get there.
Young legislators who ran, campaigned, and won their various political seats speak on the changes they have to bring on board.
I think I'll be working on this, what to take back to my people. And like one of the speakers said, he said, it's not about you getting there. It's not about you shopping up or how can I put it? It's not about you getting more promoted. Yeah, it's about you acting on the capacity of how reason why the people actually voted you. It's about you acting the capacity of what you promise the electorate, and it's about you establishing the solution in order to reform the society. So, gathering information, gathering research and knowledge, I think what I need to do is to establish that will reform my local government, my constituency, my state, and Nigeria at large. Putting in my best for a positive legislative work, and making sure all other halves of government are being involved for us to promote and to give what is needed as a country, as a legislator, as an individual.
For me, it was an entirely new sphere, a new experience entirely, but it was quite challenging, to be honest with you. And our politics is really, really challenging, and I take it to be a show that the people actually, they're looking for something different for them to have voted me in. Because, like I said previously, I've never been involved in politics. I didn't know. I went in completely green, but I was quite committed to the process. I mean, I started quite early, and I was quite committed to it. And I think the people got the message that yes, it's possible. You can have integrity. You can have people stand for what is right, and push for that. It wasn't the experience itself. The journey wasn't easy. I'll have to be honest with you. It was a very tough journey. Had so many challenges along the way from within the political sphere and even the constituents, getting them to understand what we're talking about. Because these are people that have been abused over the years. They are used to a certain, things being done a certain way. And then we came in, one, I didn't have the financial muscle that politicians are expected to have. But I went in and presented myself. And I think they got the message. And for me, it's a challenge. The challenge going to go out. What you're speaking about, I want to see it in practice. I think for me, that's a challenge right now.
We started the journey, just like why we are gathered here, Computers 2.0, or the Not Too Young to Run, and done by Yaga too. That journey has yielded what we have seen to be. And like right here, standing right by my side, is my direct successor. I'm representing Surulere State Constituency in the Akwa Ibom House of Assembly, and then this is a member elect from Surulere State Constituency in the Akwa Ibom House of Assembly. So you can see, I got in there at a young age of about early 30, and today I'm handing over to somebody who is quite younger than me. So I believe that the executive can take a cue from what is happening in the legislature. So we have had the law, we have had the act, and that is why when it came to the legislature, the speaker's conference endorsed it, and then we had to give our ratification to that act, that proposal that came to the House, and then we ratified it and sent it to the National Assembly, which was later sent to the President, and who at the end of it endorsed it. So I believe that with what is happening in the legislature, the executive can learn, knowing to whether the energy of the youth is what we need. But we equally need, most importantly, the combination of the wisdom and the world of intelligence of the elders to combine with the exuberance and the energy and the verb, the vitality of the youth to be able to get Nigeria to be where it should be. Thank you. Thank you.
The Convergence too is designed to inspire, empower and expose young elected legislators to resources and tools required for excellent public leadership and quality representation. Other speakers at the event harped on the need for the young legislators to put in all efforts and their best to ensure that their voices are heard and they work for the Nigerian youth. Remember, you can be part of this program either by way of sponsorship, participation or contributions. Our social media platforms and our numbers will be on your screen for you to be able to reach us. Until I come your way again next week, I'll leave you with a song. I am Osawoname Ibizubi.
Here I am stuck on this couch, scrolling through my notes. Heart was broken, still not growing. No. Waking up to headlines filled with devastation again. My heart is broken, but I keep going. Pain, but I won't let it turn into hate. No, I won't let it change me. Never losing sight. or the one I keep inside. Now I know it, yeah, I know it. You can't take my guilt away. Soul of mine will never pay. As long as I wake up today, you can't take my youth away. You can't take my guilt away. Soul of mine will never pay. As long as I wake up today, you can't take my youth away. You can't take my youth away. It's hard to sleep at night, knowing what's outside. Feeling hopeless, I need focus. You hit me with words I never heard come out your mouth. To be honest, I don't want it, no. Pain, but I won't let it turn into hate. No, I won't let it change me. You can't take my guilt away. Soul of mine will never pay. As long as I wake up today, can't take my youth away. You can't take my youth away. The soul of mine will never pay. As long as I wake up today, you can't take my youth away. You can't take my youth away.
In the country, I am a river down in the valley. Oh, I am a vision, and I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face, and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. I'm the world's greatest, and I'm that little bit of hope. When my back's against the ropes, I can feel it. I'm the world's greatest.